Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we are here in Computex 2024, and we are actually at MSI booth, which is amazing. With us, we have Calvin.
Thank you, Calvin. Nice to meet you again.
Nice to meet you again. It's been a year.
But
it's good to be back.
It's good to be back, yeah.
There's a lot of things that we want to talk
about. Oh yeah, there's lots of things to go over. So we'll start out with our two new next-gen motherboard from Intel. Okay, so first of all, we're here, we have our Pro Series, and our Pro Series motherboard has a new metal sleek design, and then with a couple new DIY features that we're incorporating into this year's generation motherboard. We have our second generation screwless M.2 heatsinks. So it's with just a quick latch, push it in, and it just slides right out.
Oh, nice.
There's a new mechanism as well built onto it, as well as a new M.2 clip. So it's just when you slot in the SSD, with a simple nudge to the left, it just pops right out.
So you're telling me they will never experience what it is to lose that M.2 screw under table and just
never,
you know, okay?
Never.
I love that. And I love that. So the latch implementation makes it really, really easy.
Exactly. And then with this year generation, we have incorporated our new easy PCI release slot. So a lot of people can put their fingers into the PCI slot to release the GPU. Now, with a simple click of a button, it releases the slot right now. And then that you can just grab it out, do whatever necessary changes, you're changing M.2s or a new graphics card, quick in, slot in, that's it.
Oh, that's great.
Very, very simple. Exactly.
So many times I would try to sneak my big hands inside and just can't get through.
Exactly. Like some screwdriver to, you know, poke it.
I didn't know what to say that, but yes, I've used the screwdriver. Very afraid of getting short.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. And then, right, so we'll move on to our MPG, next gen motherboard. New design, as you can see, compared to the Pro version, we have a new PCB color. It makes it more interesting with new options for PC builders to create a new variety of themes and builds. Just like the Pro Series, we have our next-gen M.2 screwless heatsinks, as well as the M.2 clip right here. So the whole piece comes off right now. As you can see, yesterday,
thank you.
your boss came over and helped us sign our motherboard. It's very valuable right now.
Thank you so much.
you can take it for a while. Bring it back later.
Yes. Yeah. No, this is amazing. I really like. So this is part of the whole thermal.
The whole thermal thing. So instead of having one by one removing it, we just into the whole slot. We increase the surface area on the heatsink, so it makes it much easier for heat to dissipate from all the Gen 5 SSDs coming from the motherboard.
Oh, that's great. I also see that you have different types of, how many slots do you have?
We have five. So one on the top and then two, three, four, five.
Wow,
so
that's all the slots.
That's a lot of expandable storage.
Yeah, that is awesome. I really like it.
Yeah.
So I like also the, you know, the finish. It's beautiful.
Yeah. All right. And then right now we have included our new debug LED. Mm-hmm. So the debug LED makes it much easier for first-time builders. If there's any problems, just look in the manual with the code and it'll just directly understand what kind of issue it is. Either it's a memory slot issue or it's like an SSD, any type of issue.
Yeah, that makes sense, because once you finish building it, you power on, this is going to cycle through different
through
codes.
All the codes, yeah,
as it's training, as the processor is reaching out and also the chips is reaching out. So like, do we have memory? Yes.
Yeah.
Do we have PCIe?
Through all the checklist, right?
Exactly. Through all the checklist. What PCIe is in, do we have? And then if it gets stuck, you'll be like, oh, I didn't see the memory correctly because that was the code
we
referenced to.
So you can just do a quick change instead of having to check everything, unplug everything. That's going to take much more time, less time consuming.
No, that's great. That's awesome. All right, so these are the next gen motherboards.
One more thing.
Oh yeah, go for it.
We have we've added and included a new 8-pin on the on this motherboard, because with new processors coming out or even new GPUs coming out, we want the motherboard to have enough sustainability throughout all the power coming from the 12 volt. So with an extra 8-pin, it's going to help alleviate all the loading from the 12 volt power rail. So it's going to help separate and, you know, put all the power connections to help sustain all the power.
Nice. So you have like a different types of power, just you just overload this one.
Yeah, instead of, yeah, we don't want to overload this because this will get really hot. So
yeah,
we want to offset the power limit. Yeah.
Keep an eye on it. No, I like it. Yep. Really good. Anything changes on the AIO that you guys have here?
We have a new Wi-Fi connector. So it's called Easy Antenna.
Mm-hmm.
So with this new design, it's just, you know, back in the day when we have to screw in the cap for the Wi-Fi, now it's just a simple slot in.
Oh, it's like a that. Push.
It's just,
oh,
just
that's
a push
really
pin.
Nice.
That's it. You don't need to screw anything. That's connected, it's secure. And then with this new base, it's magnetic as well. So you can just slap it on onto your metal case and it'll just stay right on. And if you want to, so if you don't want your Wi-Fi, just simple, unplug it.
Wow, that's pretty cool. I really like it.
Yeah,
yeah, because
exactly.
That twist and turn was difficult. And
oh,
also,
yeah.
I also saw they have a bunch of now USB-C ports back there.
Oh,
see
yeah,
a lot
yeah.
Of it
with a lot of USB-C. So a lot of new generation of I/O to speed things up when you transfer large files.
No, exactly. That's great. All right, let me give you this back before security
thank
comes
you.
Over.
No worries, we'll just put it right here.
All right, okay. So let's tell me about, these are the Z790 motherboards, but
yep.
you guys have made some changes to it.
Exactly, so for this version, from last year, we introduced the Project Zero. So what Project Zero is having all the connectors from the front of the motherboard, we have just turned it into the, we have flipped it to behind.
Oh, nice.
So all the pins and
yep.
the power rails and all that stuff, even the SATA connector, all in the back. And we want to make it much more simplistic and even much easier, especially with our new CAM2 memory modules coming into this motherboard to make it much more sleek with a new metallic and black finish. So with our new screwless design, with simple latch on, we just
oh, nice.
pop it off.
That is really nice. And this is the CAM2 module?
Yeah, exactly. That's a new CAM2 module.
What is, how big is this one?
So right now, this one is a 64 gig version.
64 gig
yeah,
version.
But there is a 128 gig version for this one, for the CAM2 version.
Now, this is pretty cool because it actually allows you to lay flat.
Exactly.
And especially that heat sink, dissipate the heat. So I really like it. It's really
exactly.
nice.
Well, for this design, we wanted to help with improve for the memory, obviously, from the frequencies. And what CAM2 does is that from traditional DIMM slots, the tracing, the circuit tracing from the memory module to the CPU is much shorter
mm-hmm.
for this version. So the connectivity and the signaling and without less interfering to both the CPU and the and
yeah, so you have a shorter tray, so the signal integrity is better, which allows
yeah.
you for higher frequencies.
And sustainability
yeah.
will be much better. Frequency will be much better.
Yeah,
well.
Yeah. The memory is very finicky about a jitter when it comes to clock and frequency.
Oh yeah, exactly. So we wanted to make it as close as possible to the CPU to
yeah.
have less interference.
That way you can crank up the speed. That's
oh,
pretty
yeah,
cool.
Exactly.
This
oh, yeah,
is what you have back here, but
yeah,
we'll take
we have a special version back
yes.
here. We can make it.
I like it a lot. And how has been the reception of the Zero project of having all this on the connection, because it makes for a beautiful build, right? It's very clean in the front.
Much more aesthetically pleasing.
Yes.
And with actually since launch from last year, we have had lots of praises, lots of good feedback from the different connectors, how it's so much more easier to build on. And when people turn on the PC for the first time, no cable clutter from the front.
The clutters in the back, and
so much easier.
And also, I've seen as we walk around Computex, I've seen there's a lot of more cases that are compatible with this type of motherboard.
So for MSI, we actually have three new dedicated Project Zero cases built in for this kind of motherboard. So hopefully, we'll have more to come in the future as well.
Awesome, that's great to hear. All right,
yeah.
So that's this one with the CAM2 memory. I also see another one here, another Z790. But
yes,
there is with a little twist.
A little twist, yes, of course. For this one, we have our Z790 MPower motherboard. So what MPower was is that it's more dedicated and created for enthusiasts and overclockers. Okay, so as you can see, it's much more smaller. And a little tiny thing is that we have a new memory module. Not just the CAM2 this year, we have
right.
a new memory module called the Mini CUDIMM. And what Mini CUDIMM is that we have collaborated with Intel to create a next generation of memory module. And what this does is that it makes the, just like the CAM2, make the circuitry much more cleaner, much more less interferable, and as well as the frequency, the sustainability, and the latency. Especially latency for overclockers is very, very important. So we try to limit, to lower the latency as much as possible to help perform, to get, world record, to beat world record. This is made to be built
World record. Yeah, so you have had like all the feedback that you get from overclockers and
yeah.
also working with Intel, like
exactly.
this is very tailored for overclockers.
It's very tailored,
yeah. Make sure that we can get those, be new records.
Yeah, so for this one, although this is just a research, still a research development product, Hopefully we can have more news coming in from MSI later on this year as well.
No, oh, that's great. No, I appreciate it. These are a lot of great things.
Yeah.
No, Calvin, thank you so much.
No worries.
Yeah, it's great to see you. It's great
and
to see you again.
Nice to meet you. Hopefully I see you next year again.
Yes, hopefully.
Hopefully.
All right, and now we're here with Andy, and we're going to be talking about this amazing laptop that have Lunar Lake. So I can't wait to tell you guys. And with us, we have Andy.
Thank you for coming. Yeah, this is the MSI booth at Computex 2024. And right now, you're seeing those beautiful laptops featuring the latest Core Ultra with the codename Lunar Lake.
Yeah. This is awesome. Actually, yeah. I own one of these Prestige 16s AI, the previous generation. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, I love that computer. They're so light, durable, and the performance is amazing. So I can't hardly wait. All right, yeah, tell me more about this one.
Yeah, glad to hear that, you know, the efficiency will be the biggest spotlight of the Lunar Lake. So, you know, everything on this processor is brand new. But, you know, in this place, at this time frame, everybody care about its AI capability, right? Because that's the thing of the whole Computex AI PC. So I would say the new processor is totally compatible to those new standard of the Copilot Plus PC, which needs the MPU featuring over 40 TOPS, which is 48. So it's a totally qualified AI PC, Copilot Plus PC. But something even nicer is that thanks to the superior power efficiency of the Lunar Lake processor and 99.9 watts battery on this model,
wow,
which is the, you know, maximum limit you can carry on the airplane. If you carry on with the 100 watt, you will be banned.
They'll send you back home.
Yeah. So I would say we can expect something even more impressive in terms of battery life.
Yeah, I mean, and battery is so important nowadays, especially when I was traveling to Taiwan, I definitely mm-hmm. needed that extra battery life to make sure I got a lot of the work done on the way here.
Exactly, yeah.
So can you talk a little bit about, like, I mean, I can see there's type A's, I saw some RJ45s in the IOs in this laptop.
I will say that's another spotlight of this kind of device. You know, we have a lot of things like 16-inch laptop in the market, right?
Right.
But all of them choose the way to sacrifice those I/O port. But right. That's not a story of the Prestige 16 AI Plus. You know, it not just having dual Thunderbolt 4 ports, he also got all those ports that you and me will use daily, such as Type A, HDMI, and guess what? Even the RJ45 LAN port and full size of the SD card reader, which is essential for you guys, right?
Yeah, full size, for all my guys behind the camera and also the content media creators.
Yes.
A full size SD card is amazing, especially in events like this.
Yeah.
And also, you not only have it on the 16-inch, you also have it in 14-inch, if I'm correct.
Yeah, exactly. For the Prestige, actually, we have a complete family ranging from 16-inch, 40-inch, and 30-inch. And I would say, if you want to give you a shared biggest feature of them, I would say battery life. You know, on our 40-inch model, it features 90 watts battery, which is something you will have never on other 40-inch model. And even for the 30-inch, you know how light it is? I mean, 990 grams. Sorry, I don't know how to translate it in pounds. Maybe less than three, maybe. But even though, it still features 75 watts battery.
Wow.
So basically said, even in the Meteor Lake era, you can expect over 16 hours of battery life on all of our Prestige family. And that was said, just what I said, we can expect more with the new
Lunar Lake. Yes, the new changes on power management and also the optimizations. It's great. It is a great laptop. I use it daily and I really like it a lot. Before we begin, you can see that there's a plexiglass right up here. And the reason of that is because at CES, I try to run away with a claw.
This is great, man, and thank you for it.
Okay.
I'm more than happy to. Oh, wait, look at that.
So they learned their lesson that not to have this latest claw version out in the public for me so I can run away with it. So Andy, tell us about this guy. Who's this guy? This is brand new.
Yeah, it's sort of brand new, and I will say this is one of the big star of the handheld in Computex 2024. This is the Claw 8. And from its name you can tell, it's even bigger in size, so it can somehow give you even more immersive gaming experience. And of course, the reason why we protect it so much is actually it comes with a new Core Ultra processor with the codename Lunar Lake. Yeah. So you will know how efficient it is. But I would say just take a look at what's the IO dual Thunderbolt 4 ports. Yeah, so you can do even more versatile with these kind of things. And yeah. I would say we have a series of refinement on this model, and all of them is not inspired by ourselves, but by our users. Like even more better gripping, dual Thunderbolt 4 ports, as you can see, even larger battery, and also change the switch of the LB and also RB button to make it more even more tactile.
Oh, that's yeah. great, because you guys, so all these changes that you have done to this, yeah. not only the processor with all the performance and power yes. savings, but you've been listening to the community about yes. the first version, which is here.
Yeah.
And they say like, oh, we would like these little changes to make it even better.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's awesome.
And there's one more thing, you know, we saw that a lot of people have some opinion about the charger we have for the first iteration. And we also changed the new one to the wall-mounted charger, which is more convenient to bring.
Nice, yes, I can see that.
Yeah.
No, and it seems to me that did it change the size of the screen for
yes.
this?
Yes, actually for the new Claw, which should be available around the third quarter of this year.
Oh, wow.
We will have the 8-inch and also the 7-inch one.
Oh, so it comes in two different
yeah,
sizes.
Yeah, yeah, you can choose on your own. I mean,
oh, this is great, I love it. And I mean, I like the color. I mean, I can't wait to play with it, but it looks amazing.
Yeah, me too. I already pre-ordered with our sales in Taiwan, you know.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
No, well, thank you, Andy. I really like this. It's amazing. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
My pleasure to help.